In 1984, Guillermo Ruggier discovered something one of a kind in the southernmost tip of Argentina. The skeleton was a sauropod that belonged to such a unique group that Ruggier's discovery has been the only one of its kind. The skeletal remains proved to be a pivotal moment for paleontologists around the globe because not only was this a new genus of dinosaurs, but the remains confirm of Dicraeosauridae in South America. The Amargasaurus kazooi lived during the early Cretaceous period, a time known for its titan-like rulers, and witnessed the largest land and sea animals known to man. Despite the fact the Amargasaurus was on the small side of history, measuring in at approximately 32 feet in length and 8.2 feet in height, the Amargasaurus was extremely small for a sauropod and only weighed an expected 8 to 18 tons. The remains of this particular dinosaur were discovered relatively complete in 1984. Guillermo Ruggier led his 8th expedition in South America with a program to help scientists better understand Jurassic and Cretaceous tetrapods. Upon discovery, it was noticed that nearly all of the skeletal remains stayed intact and grouped. The only significant pieces missing were from the skull, a quarter of the tail, and hand bones from the legs. However, paleontologists were able to agree with some certainty what the basic look of a Amargasaurus head was. They managed to do this by basing their ideas on other related sauropods with similar skull material. Unearthing the Amargasaurus was important because it was the only known species of dinosaurs within this genus, and because it revealed a phylogenetic relationship with late Jurassic Dictriosaurid fossils discovered in Africa. This means that the fossils found in various African deposits and the Amargasaurus shared the same ancestor early in time. Puzzle pieces such as this assist scientists and scholars who are trying to piece together Earth's history before man. Located in the Neuquén Basin, Argentina, the La Amarga Formation is a geologic formation and is the oldest Cretaceous terrestrial formation in the area. Amargasaurus wasn't the only fossil found in the area or during the previous expeditions. This goes to show that Earth's history is rich and vast beneath our feet. Sauropoda is a clade of saurischian dinosaurs who had a couple of notable and famous features about them. Members of this clade are called sauropods, and these animals were known to be quite large. They were quadrupedal herbivores with very long necks, long whip-like tails, small heads, and four pillar-like legs. Dinosaurs like the brontosaurus were a part of this clade. Sauropods were known to be high browsers, having their heads in the trees instead of the bushes. Many members of the clade were able to briefly rear onto their hind legs to reach delicious vegetation that was out of their reach for their long necks. Amargasaurus is perhaps the weirdest dinosaur researchers have discovered in ages. All dinosaurs have specific traits that allow paleontologists to classify and group them. But the Amargasaurus has such unusual characteristics. Amargasaurus was best known for its morphology, which consisted of not one, but two rows of long spined bones running down its back. While Amargasaurus is not the only dinosaur to have spines across its back, it's an unusual trait for a sauropod. That wasn't the only defining feature, though. Amargasaurus was extremely small compared to early Cretaceous period sauropods. If this animal were alive today, however, it would be the largest land animal on Earth, as it would be nearly twice the size of African savanna elephants. The small stumpy sides of Amargasaurus made it a low browsing herbivore, meaning it ate vegetation from forest floors and low hanging brush. The two rows of spines on the Amargasaurus have researchers scratching their heads. As unique of a trait as it was, nobody quite knows what the spines would have looked like or what their purpose was. It's thought that because of the size of Amargasaurus, the spines were likely long spikes and not sails. The spines are thought to be roughly a meter in height and stand up vertically from the Amargasaurus' back. In fact, scientists believe the bone to have been incredibly dense and covered in a layer of keratin, the same compound that can be found on the horns of today's rhinoceros. Many scientists do imagine the spikes being connected by flesh to create a sail, but others believe that due to an evolutionary survival trait, the spines were protective spikes. Countless hypotheses have been considered. The spines acted as deterrent for predators, self-defense, and balance. Few scientists have even explored the possibility of the spikes being glorious displays to attract mates, like peacocks, fawning their beautiful feathers. Another possible use for the spikes could have been to regulate body temperature. The early Cretaceous period was considerably warmer than it is today, and the spines on the Amargasaurus back would have allowed for controlled air movement over its body to cool the dinosaur down. Before I get into the strangest facts about the Amargasaurus, please take a second to consider subscribing to my channel and liking the video. It really helps out small creators like myself. The idea of the Amargasaurus having sails instead of spikes is still possible. Some scientists believe the two rows of spine bones would have supported twin sails spanning from the neck to the very tip of their spine. The main problem with this idea, however, is that dual skin sails would have resulted in an extremely rigid neck. In return, this would have caused a serious encumbrance of feeding and drinking habits. Countless speculations continue to circulate regarding the meaning and appearance of the Amargasaurus spines, but several characteristics have clearly been proven. As such, we know that the Amargasaurus feasted on vegetation. The long neck and long legs would have allowed the animal to trek treacherous terrain. Their teeth were long, but blunt and not sharp. This is a trait common with herbivores because their teeth weren't meant for chewing. Instead, the dinosaur would close its mouth around a tasty-looking branch and scrape its teeth down the wood. This would pull the leaves off the branch with ease and slide down the animal's throat. Scientists believe that based on modern-day herbivores, Amargasaurus would have eaten stones as well. The stones would stay in their stomachs and would help to break up and digest the rough plant material. Dicreosaurid sauropods, a relative to Amargasaurus, are usually viewed as low-browsing feeders. Low-browsing sauropods are considered a niche feeding group and are thought to be yet another evolutionary trait they developed so that they could avoid direct competition with the increasing sizes of the titanosaurs that were rampant in South America. As for the rest of the body, studies have been conducted on the partial skull remains. The findings indicate that while Amargasaurus was alive, it likely held its head down, with its mouth pointing towards the ground, as opposed to pointing perfectly horizontally or toward the sky. This information was revealed after a model of the inner ear revealed that if horizontally registered as 0 and vertically as 90, then the Amargasaurus snout would have been pointed toward the ground at approximately 65 degrees. During the study and reconstruction of the inner ear, scientists also revealed that Amargasaurus probably had pretty bad hearing too. Further research was conducted, and it's believed that Amargasaurus may not have been able to lift its head off the ground as much as previously thought. Based on the skeletal structure, researchers know that unlike other big sauropods, Amargasaurus wouldn't have been able to reach on its hind legs very much. Furthering this research, it is believed that a small range of motion was possible, but to a lesser extent than first believed. The Amargasaurus is a mysterious, one-of-a-kind dinosaur. Their characteristics resemble their clad members, but, at the same time, are considered to be the black sheep. In the past 3 decades, several new fossils have emerged, but none have had the scientists scratching their heads harder than Amargasaurus still does today. What are your thoughts on the Amargasaurus? Do you think it had sails, like some scientists believe?